Hello students, how are you all? I am Miss Pinky Suhail from St. John's High School, your English teacher of class 4th. I will teach you the lesson from English Literature Book, Oxford Reading Circle, Book 4. The chapter name is A Legend of Rubezahl. A Legend of Rubezahl is a short story adopted from a German folktale written by Johann Carl August, was born on March 29, 1735 and he died on October 28, 1787. He was one of the finest story writer of fairy tales, remember for his graceful and delicately version of popular folk tales. So I am going to start the lesson with the picture of some occupations. I hope you all will enjoy this lesson. Concentrate it carefully because at the last you will get the home task. Student, you can see pictures of some occupation on your screen. There is doctor, policeman, gardener, teacher. So this story is based on a poor man who is a glazier. Glazier means a person who cuts and fits glass into doors and windows. And second main character in this story is Rubezahl, a mountain sprite. Sprite mean an elf or fairy like a small magical person. So this was the short introduction of the story. In these paragraphs there are few vocabulary words which I will read for your better pronunciation and I will give you the meaning of it. The words are glazier, narrow, sprite, vanished, rapidly, smashed. I repeat it again. Glazier, narrow, sprite, vanished, rapidly, smashed. Glazier mean a person who cuts and fits glass into doors and windows. Narrow mean a small size of width. Sprite mean an elf or fairy like small magical person. Vanished mean disappear suddenly and completely. Rapidly mean very quickly. Smashed mean violently. So let's start the reading. Take out page number 9. Once upon a time, a glazier was traveling across the mountains. The mountain path was narrow, dusty and covered in small sharp stones. To the sides of the path were prickly shrubs and boulders. In the sky above, the sun shone brightly, which made the glazier's load feel heavier. The glazier was a good man who worked hard. He was feeling very tired from carrying the heavy load of glass. So he began to look about for a place where he could rest. In this paragraph, the story starts with a man who is glazier. He is traveling across the mountains. The mountain path was narrow and covered in small sharp stone, prickly shrubs and boulders. Boulders mean a big stone, big round stones, and the sun shone brightly, which made the glazier's load feel heavier. Glazier was a good and hard working man. He was feeling tired and looking for a place where he could rest. Let's start the second paragraph. Rubezahl, a mountain sprite, had been watching the glazier for some time. As soon as he saw that the glazier was looking for a place to stop, he skipped ahead around a bend in the path and changed himself into a little mound covered in soft grass that looked like a comfortable place to rest. When the glazier discovered the mound in his way, he smiled and, feeling well pleased, he put down the glass and sat himself down. "Ah, that's better," he said, but his joy was not to last. After just a few minutes, the mound vanished from under him so rapidly that the poor glazier fell to the ground with his glass. The fall smashed the glazier's glass into 1,000 pieces. In the second paragraph, Rubezahl, a mountain sprite, watching the glazier. As soon as he saw glazier was looking for a place to rest, he changed himself into a little mound, like a comfortable place. When glazier found a place, he smiled and feeling well pleased, because he was too tired, but his joy was not to last. After a few minutes, a mound vanished, and poor glazier fell to the ground with his glass and glass broken into 1,000 pieces. Okay, student, let's start the last paragraph of this session. The poor fellow arose from the ground and looked around him, but the mound of earth had disappeared. The glazier began to wail, groaned bitterly. "Oh no, oh no, my family will go hungry." He sighed with heartfelt sorrow over his bad luck and looked in dismay at the glass shards scattered around him. How was he going to earn any more money? In this paragraph, the poor glazier arose himself from the ground and looked around him, but the mound of earth had disappeared. The poor man began to cry and groan bitterly and worried about his family. He sighed heartfelt sorrow over his bad luck, and now how was he earn any more money for his family? Students, you can see your home task on your screen. There are three questions. Question number one is, read pages 11 and 12. Question number 2, find out the meaning of given words from dictionary. The words are cruel, number 2, mischievous. Question number 3 is, why was the glazier feeling tired? Okay, student, note this. Complete the given homework on a foolscape sheet, punch it in a file, and submit in the school office every Wednesday at 9 to 11 with your name and class on it. ओके बाय स्टूडेंट, स्टे होम स्टे सेफ।